In this video, let us draw the ER diagram for the topic online shopping. The first step is we need to choose the entities. So for online shopping, product must be there, and for buying that product, a customer must be there. So the first two entities are product and customer. So product, it is an object, so therefore it is an entity. Next, it is customer. Customer is physically existing and it is an object. Therefore, customer is also an entity. So, these two must be written inside a rectangular box. Next, after the customer buys that product, like after the customer selects that product, it will be put in the cart item. So, cart item is also conceptually existing. So, therefore, it is also an entity and it must be written inside a rectangular box. Next, payment. After buying the product, the customer must pay. So, therefore, payment is also conceptually existing and it is an entity and it must be written inside a rectangular box. So, these are the entities. So, now let us draw those entities. So, customer is the first entity. It must be written inside a rectangular box. Next, online shopping only we are doing. So, this online shopping, it is conceptually existing and it is also an object. So, therefore, this is an entity. It must be written inside a rectangular box. Next, product. So, only if the product is there, the customer can buy. Next is the cart item. So, the item that the customer has selected. Next, it is cart. Then, payment. So, these are all the entities. Now, for each entity, we must write its attributes, that is its characteristics. So for customer, there will be some name. And this name, it can be further divided into three as first name, middle name and last name. Then customer will have an address. Then customer will have a phone number and this must be written inside double ovals because the customer can have more than one phone number. It is not necessary that the customer should have only one phone number. So therefore, this is having multi-values. Like more than one phone number is there means multi-value it is. So therefore, this phone number is a multi-value attribute. So, it must be written inside double oval. So, this is finished. And this name is the composite attribute because we are able to divide this name further as first name, middle name and last name. Next is the product. The product will have some name. That is product name. Next, the product will have some price. So, the product's price. Then, the model of that product. So, these are the attributes for this product entity. Next, cart item. Quantity is important. Now, if the customer has selected two dresses, then the quantity will be two in the cart item. Next, for those two dresses, what is the total cost? So, that is also important in cart item. Next, payment. So, under payments, the amount is an attribute. Then, payment type is an attribute. So, whether you're going to pay through GPay or PhonePay or some other payment mode. So, payment type is also important and the amount is also important. Now, we have to connect all the entities using a relationship. That is, we need to draw the diamond boxes, and through lines we must connect these entities. So from customer to payment, I'm going to draw a relationship, and inside this diamond box I'm going to write DAS. And then from payment to cart, I'm going to connect through a diamond, through a diamond shape, and then I'm going to write done for. So customer does payment. So customer is paying after buying the product, and payment is done for the items that were there in the cart. So that is the meaning for this. Actually, this is the last part. We should go like this. So the customer, here I should draw a diamond box. So inside this diamond box, I should write belongs to. So the customer belongs to online shopping. So the customer has come here for shopping online. Next, we should connect it with product. So online shopping has various products, and the products were added to. So inside this diamond box, added to will come. Next, from this cart item, I should connect another diamond box and write made of inside this. So now let us see the flow. The customer belongs to online shopping. So the customer wants to do shopping online. Next, in online shopping, there are many various products. So online shopping has various products. So the customer is choosing the product that he or she wants and putting it as a cart item. Then the customer is paying the amount for that item. So this is the flow. So this is the ER diagram for online shopping. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get the new video updates. And please don't forget to share it with your friends. It may be very helpful for them. Thank you.